Today we will study the fourth poem of Flamingo, A Thing of Beauty. A Thing of Beauty is a very nice romantic poem written by John Keats. John Keats was a great romantic poet in English literature. He was born in 1795 and died in 1821. He survived only 25 years, but in short span of his life, he contributed a lot for the society. He was a great scholar. Unfortunately, his health did not support him. He had been suffering from illness, but in short life, he was fond of love and poetry. This piece of poem has been taken from his famous book Endymion, a poetic romance. In this poem, he has focused on the importance of a beauty of nature. According to him, a beauty of nature has power to solve all type of problems in the world. So, from the text, the first line is, a thing of beauty is a joy forever. This is a very important line. Or, the meaning of this line is, a thing of beauty gives a constant pleasure. Permanently pleasure we find from a thing of beauty. Its loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness. According to him, really a thing of beauty gives a regular pleasure. Its beauty increases. And it will never pass into nothingness. That means we do not get the negative aspect from a thing of beauty. But we keep a bower quiet for us, and a sleep full of sweet dreams, and health and quiet breathing. So a thing of beauty really helps us like a bower, just like a tired traveler's sit under the tree, the shadow of the tree, and feel comfort and relief. Like that we find, we get protection from a thing of beauty. And it also really, it gives the sound health, sound sleep, positive thinking, and sound health. Therefore, on every morrow, are we reading flowery band to bind us to the earth. Really a thing of beauty, that means nature attracts us. That is the reason every morrow, that means every morning, people go near the plants or the flowers. Purpose is the flower plants, really the flower plants attract the people, or that is the reason people go to the flower plants for choosing the flowers. Therefore, on every morrow are we reading a flowery band to bind us to the earth. In spite of despondence, of the inhuman dearth of noble nature's of the gloomy days, of all the unhealthy and over darkened ways. So here the poet has also focused on the cause of suffering, why people suffer, and according to him, people are responsible. The reason is inhuman activities. Gloomy days, that means the natural calamity or bad ways. There are three causes the suffering of the people, as the poet has mentioned in this poem. Yes, in spite of all, but here we find that the poet has also focused on the solution, because people are responsible for suffering and solution is a thing of beauty. In spite of all, some shape of beauty moves away the fall from our dark spirits. So the dark spirits create problem before us, but a thing of beauty has power to remove all the beauty, moves away the fall from our dark spirits, such the sun, the moon, trees old and young, sprouting a shady boon for simple sea and such the daffodils. So according to him, really a thing of beauty has power to remove all the problems, all that means covering. And here also he has mentioned a thing of beauty, or as examples he has given the sun, the moon, trees, animals and flowers. They are the least of a thing of beauty, and they have power to remove all sorts of problems. That for themselves a cooling covert make against the hot season, the mid forest brake rich with a sprinkling of fair musk rose blooms. So in the forest we find that the brake, the reels, the flowers really create the beautiful scene, and when people visit and enjoy. So, and such too is the grandeur of the dooms we have imagined for the mighty day. Our lovely tales that we have heard of it, an endless fountain of immortal drink, powering unto us from the heaven's brink. So, at the last stanza we find that we have imagined for the mighty day and lovely tales. Really mighty day, that means our great ancestors. We people think that our great ancestors live in the heaven, and after knowing that they are living in the heaven, and after listening the lovely tales, really we people enjoy a lot. But here the poet has compared, if we are living in the lap of nature, that means our life is superior to the people living in the heaven. So the poet says that if the people are living in the lap of nature, that means they are taking the immortal drink, they are taking the elixir coming from the heaven, and directly men are taking the elixir, that means immortal drink. So now we will discuss some important questions from the text. List the things of beauty mentioned in the poem. The first question from this text is, list the things, the beauty mentioned in the poem. The list of things are the sun, the moon, the animals, the trees, the flowers, the reels, the bricks, etc. The second question is, list the things that cause suffering and pain. Really, the things that create suffering, that's the inhuman activities, gloomy days or bad ways, they are the cause of suffering. Next question is, what are the line, therefore, are we reading a flowery band to bind us to the earth, suggest to you? So really, a thing of beauty attract us. But that is the reason people go to choose the flower near the flower plants. What makes human beings love life in spite of troubles and sufferings? Really, a thing of beauty has power to remove all the problems, all the troubles and sufferings. Why is grandeur associated with the mighty dead? Really, mighty dead live in heaven, as people think, and become very happy. Next question, do we experience things of beauty only for short moments, or do they make a lasting impression on us? Really, a thing of beauty gives a constant pleasure, and for everlasting it sustains. What image does the poet use to describe the beautiful bounty of the earth? Really, nature is God, and we learn a lot from the beauty of nature. Now then, we will discuss some questions on the basis of the extract. So extract number one, a thing of beauty is a joy forever, its loveliness increases, it will never pass into nothingness, but will keep a boar quiet for us and sleep full of sweet dreams and health and quiet breathing. The first question is, name poem and the poet. A Thing of Beauty by John Keats. Second question is, what does Keats mean by a thing of beauty? All the objects on the earth, according to poet, a thing of beauty. And a thing of beauty really gives pleasure. Second question is, what does the poet pay tribute to objects of beauty? What does the poet pay tribute to objects of beauty? That means really it gives protection, it gives sound health, sound sleep or positive thinking. Extract number two, therefore on every morrow are we reading a flowery band to bind us to the earth, in spite of despondence, of the inhuman dirt, of noble natures, of the gloomy days, of all the unhealthy and over darkened ways made for our searching. So the questions on the basis of this passage, what does the reading of a flowery garland suggest? That means the reading of flowery garland suggests a thing of beauty attract us. And that is the reason every morning people go to choose the flower near the flower plants. List the causes of pain and suffering. Inhuman activities, gloomy days and bad ways, they are the cause of suffering. Next, what makes human beings love life in spite of troubles and sufferings? So, a thing of beauty makes human beings love life in spite of troubles and sufferings. Next extract, and such to be the grandeur of the dooms we have imagined for the mighty day, all lovely tales that we have heard or read, an endless fountain of immortal dream pouring unto us from the heaven's brink. That means, see, here the first question from this extract, why is grandeur associated with the fall of mighty heroes? Real, the mighty dead live in heaven. And after knowing that, people enjoy. And we people are also associated with a great personality, our ancestor, just like Gandhi. just like Bhagat Singh, Chandrasekhar Azad, we enjoy because they are living in heaven. What is the immortal dream? Second question is, what is the immortal dream? That means, if people are living in the life of nature, that means they are living or they are taking the immortal dream. So the poet has focused on the beauty of, importance of a thing of beauty, that means a thing of nature. That means he loves nature, he likes nature, or one who lives in the life of nature, the people are living in heaven according to poet.